Everybody, this is Chris from livingflylegacy.com. I wanted to show you how to tie up the artimouse. The reason I called it the artimouse is because it's articulated as two hooks, as you see there. And I start out with the two hooks. So it's a gamagatsu size 2 octopus hook, and the front of the fly is actually a 4x streamer hook in size 2 also. To start out tying the fly, you're going to need your foam. I use the 3mm sheets. I just bought them from Walmart, and I got 6 sheets, and I just use spray adhesive. And you need to give them a pretty generous coat in between. If you don't, they will kind of separate when you're trying to tie with them. So once you spray that, you let it dry. I let it cure for about a day is what I did. You cut out strips, and these strips are about, oh geez, I mean you can kind of see there, it's about an inch wide, and I cut the sections about an inch and a half long, then I trim the head to a point, and then what you see me doing here is I'm actually just taking a little bit of the white off of the edges. I'm going to use the white as the top of it so I can just see it a little bit better when I'm fishing it. And then the bottom, I'm going to trim the edges so it kind of gets, I don't know, a little bit more curvature. So when it's cutting through the water, it'll, I don't know, it gives it a little bit more of a V wake as it's going through. Once you get that all cut out like that, you take a razor blade or scissors and you cut a section down the middle. And then you'll be able to glue it onto the hook, and I glue it at about a 30 degree angle to the hook. And the reason I do that is so when I'm pulling it, when I'm stripping the line, that it kind of makes it wake. It kind of tries to push the fly up on top of the water, and you just use some super glue in that little slit there that you made. Move the hook around a little bit to get the glue all around it, and then you pinch it, and then you'll just have to wait a minute for it to kind of hold together. Once it holds together, just set it aside and it can dry while you move on to the back end of the fly. Another thing I had to do right here though, because I didn't use enough spray adhesive with this section, or I mean with these sheets, is I just put a little bit more super glue around the edges because I just wanted to make sure they weren't going to come apart. And you can do that if you're worried that that might happen on you. It's not a bad idea to reinforce the fly. Then you set the head aside to dry. Next, you just want to get the legs ready. I just used medium round rubber legs here. I tied 4 pieces together, and what I'm going to do is furl them. And that sounds kind of weird, but basically what you do is you take 2 pieces and you just twist them one direction, and you hold that while you grab the other side and you twist them the opposite direction. And twist them quite a ways. If any of you are familiar with furled leaders, this is how you make a furled leader. Well, kind of. I mean, it's the principle behind it. Once you get them both twisted pretty well, what you'll do is you'll hold the 2 separate twisted sections together, and you'll let the end go, and it'll furl. They'll twist around each other and kind of hold. I tried braiding them, but it doesn't really work very well to braid them, so I figured that I found out that furling them works pretty well. And then you'll just tie a knot in the other side where you want the end of your leg to be. So you have a knot on one side and a knot on the other side. And I do about 2 inches, maybe 2.5 or 3, I don't know. You just kind of got to use your eye. And then you clip off the ends, and what happens is the little pieces on the ends actually look like legs. They look like, I mean, the feet that dangle out there. And that'll be the legs that protrude from the 2 back sides. And if you notice that with mice, the way they swim, they kick their legs out on the sides. And so that's the whole reason I use that, is to kind of look like the mouse is actually trying to swim. So you start with, once you get all that other stuff done, you get your hook, and your second hook, your gamagatsu, and grab what's going to be your tail section. And I just used some cheaper rabbit strip. You want the skinnier stuff. You don't want the Magnum so much for the tail. Might be, I guess you could use it, but it's a little too wide. Well, you get that, trim the hair off, except for the very tip at the end. Then you'll tie your legs in here. And I just kind of tie them across the top, and then I'll pull them back at a downward angle, because you want them to to sit underneath the water, look like the mouse is kicking, and you want them to not get in the way of your hooks. So you just pull them back and down, and you don't tie them so close that they'll just stick right in line with the tail. You want them to still stick out to the side. Once you get that tied in, then you're going to tie in your rabbit strip. And cross-cut rabbit strip's really nice if you have it, to tie the cross-cut in so it's headed toward the front of the toward the eye, but regular rabbit strip works just fine. That's what I'm using here. The cross-cut's nice because it'll actually keep a little bit more body with the fly when you stop stripping. It'll push it out, the fur will push out a little bit better. Anyway, once you get that tied in, you wrap it around to the front of the fly. You wrap your thread and then whip finish it. You want a pretty stout thread so you can really tighten down on your on that leather, on that rabbit strip. Make sure it's not going anywhere. And that's pretty much it for the back section. For the tail, I tried chamois towel and it works really well for movement. I really like the look of it, but the problem is when you're actually fishing the fly, it tangles up around the hooks a lot easier than leather, because regular rabbit strip leather is a little bit less supple. So you can try it with the chamois, see if you like it. I like it for the movement. It's just when you're using it at night, it's kind of a pain to keep untangling it. During the day, you can kind of keep an eye on it easier. And I'm moving on now to the front section of the fly. My head's pretty well dry. I'm tying in some 20-pound CXX mono here for my connection point. I try and tie the first part of it on the underside of the hook, and then the second part I try and put on the top so it keeps the articulation point in a vertical direction, so it'll swim side to side. And then I put a little super glue on there to make sure it's not going to slip out, and wrap my thread aways around it, and then bring it to the back. Now I'm going to tie in the front rabbit strip. You can use whatever color rabbit strip you like. If you look at most field mice, their underbelly is a white color, and their top is like a gray or a brown. Some are even black, but most mice will have white on their underbelly, so it's not a bad thing to have a little bit brighter color. This is some weird color. It's like chinchilla or something. I can't even remember what it said, but it's a nice blend. I like the blends. They kind of make it look a little bit more natural. In the beginning, now I'm just going to tie it off right behind the head, which is a little tricky with how big the head is there, but you'll notice when I trimmed the tail, it had all that extra fur. I kept the fur off of the tail, and the reason I do that is when I get done, I'm going to actually put a little bit of super glue underneath the head and then just attach that extra fur, just to give it a little bit more natural look if I'm going to fish it during the day. If you're going to use this just primarily for nighttime, it's not, I mean, you don't really need to do this, but I fish them during the day too, and so it kind of gives it a little bit more natural look underneath, a little less artificial. The reason I tied this fly the way I did with the articulation is I looked at the way mice swim, and they really kick their legs out quite a bit, and it causes their hind end to move back and forth a lot while they're in the water. And I wanted a fly that gave that movement, and the single hooked flies don't allow quite that movement back and forth, and this really does. It also causes the tail to swim in a way that is really tantalizing to the fish. The reasoning behind the head and the orientation is so it swims through the water, but also The reason I have the big foam head is I want the head to be out of the water, but the rest of the body to be under the water. That's how a lot of mice actually swim, is their back section is in the water, but their head is out of the water. So I've had a lot of success with this pattern. I hope you have fun with it and tie some up. Good luck.
You've been mousercised!